So up here in the north of Iceland, in 1720, this would have been a wild place to be. Lava flows came pouring down from a fissure eruption into the lake. And as these lava flows hit the lake, explosions happened, producing this incredible landscape of mini cones, each cone representing its own steam explosion as steam burst up through the lava flow to make its own little crater. We call these rootless cones because they have no roots. There's no magma feeding them from below. So now up on the top of Vierfell, the tuff cone volcano. So tuff cones, typically about a kilometer in diameter. Classic morphology of a kind of wide ring and made mostly of tuff, as the name suggests. When lava interacts with, in this case, lake water and explodes and probably produces one event that may last for weeks or maybe months, but characteristic explosions of airfall and small pyroclastic flows and ballistic rocks like this raining down to build up the cone. So the deposits produced by tuff cones are these poorly sorted blocks, bombs, and fine-grained ash from phreatomagmatic explosions. These were probably deposited in a series of pyroclastic surges that would come fountaining over the edge of the tuff cone and deposit down the flanks. You can imagine ballistics like this landing all around, creating these ballistic-strewn flanks of the volcano on top of the surge deposits. So out on the skyline behind me we have Krapla Caldera, a much bigger volcano than anything we've seen so far on this trip. Calderas form when the magma chamber erupts such a large volume of pyroclastic flows that the land actually subsides, creating this wide depression known as a caldera. There are so many small volcanoes within Krapla Caldera, it's actually quite hard to see in the morphology of the landscape.